Over the past 24 hours, we have seen a revolution in consciousness, although it didn't seem that way. Just yesterday, PewDiePie, who has the largest single individual YouTube internet audience in the world, announced that he was going to give $50,000 to the Anti-Defamation League, or the ADL, because, and then he went on to say how the ADL fights hate speech.
I'm donating $50,000 to Anti-Defamation League, which is an organization that fights bigotry and prejudice in all its forms.
What happened over the 24 hours must have come as a surprise to PewDiePie and the ADL and everyone else involved in this scenario.
That's a lie. They're extremely vicious organization when it comes to targeting individuals that they do not agree with.
24 hours later, PewDiePie went on, made an announcement that he is not going to give any money to the ADL.
I need to make an announcement. We thought it would be nice to donate to a charity as a way to celebrate. I made the mistake of picking a charity that I was advised instead of picking a charity that I'm personally passionate about. The whole internet just didn't believe it. Like, why is he donating to his charity? Look at his face. To be fair, I saw it as an opportunity to put an end to these alt-right claims that has been thrown against me. I knew it wasn't perfect, but I also didn't know a lot of things that surfaced throughout this whole thing about the charity that doesn't fit at all. So I understand why people had concerns about it. And these are things that I would have known myself if I had just taken my time. It really doesn't feel genuine for me to proceed with a donation at this point, and I instead wanted to actually do take my time. I'm sorry for all the confusion, and I'm sorry for messing this up.
What happened during this period of time is that PewDiePie ran into consciousness, the consciousness that exists out there among the people that he's supposed to be leading. Those people now understand that the ADL is not some disinterested philanthropical organization that fights for their rights. The ADL is the main author of the hate speech censorship campaign that has swept through places like YouTube on the internet. The ADL is involved in thought control. The ADL is the commissar that enforces psychological warfare on the population at large. Psychological warfare is the disruption of prohibited speech among subject peoples. Anyone who disagrees with the ADL will be demonized. The ADL has the power to ruin their careers, ruin their livelihood with total impunity. In the Soviet Union, this was done by state organizations. In the United States, it's done by privatized entities like the ADL. This brings us to the understanding that PewDiePie bumped into. What is the ADL? Somebody knew, even if he didn't. The ADL is a money laundering operation. It is a domestic espionage organization that spies on you, keeps files on you, and will use this material to destroy you if you do anything that they do not like. That is what they've been from the beginning. In exchange for contributions, the ADL will do its best to keep Jewish criminals out of jail. This has been their history from the beginning. I've already written a book about it. It's called How Meyer Lansky Took Over the Cincinnati Ballet. It's available on Amazon Kindle. Now, Meyer Lansky, notorious criminal, made significant contributions to the ADL. It didn't work because the ADL at that time didn't have the clout that it has now. But Meyer Lansky's granddaughter did end up working for the ADL. Mo Dalitz, another notorious Jewish criminal who was involved in rum running during Prohibition. He was head of the Jewish Navy in Cleveland that brought illegal booze into the United States from Canada. He was involved in gambling and prostitution in gay places like Newport, Kentucky, and he got run out of town by a Catholic prosecutor in Newport, Kentucky. That story is also in How Meyer Lansky Took Over the Cincinnati Ballet. In 1984, we reached a crucial turning point here. 1984, Mo Dalitz had given enough money to the ADL so that they then gave him their Torch of Liberty Award. At this point, Mo Dalitz was no longer a gangster. He was legit, and anybody who said he was a gangster would be accused of being an anti-Semite. 1984 is also a crucial year because this is the year that the ADL got in bed with the FBI, collaborating on what they said were hate crimes, which basically diverted the FBI from going after real criminals like Meyer Lansky and Mo Dallas and getting them to apprehend or harass the people the ADL didn't like, which were then known as hate groups. Didn't stop there. The ADL was the bagman in the operation that got Mark Rich pardoned by President Clinton. The ADL gave an award to a certain Mr. Kirshner in Florida, and he was the one who arranged the sweetheart deal that got the late Jeffrey Epstein off the hook. So we have a consistent pattern here. The consistent pattern all of a sudden reached a tipping point. Okay, there was probably a moment in time where PewDiePie could have said, ADL, money, $50,000, and everybody would have cheered or no one would have objected, but those days are over. The consciousness is rising, logos is rising now. We all know what a false flag operation is, and we didn't know that before. We now know what the ADL is, and PewDiePie had to find that out the hard way. We will continue to use our YouTube channel, but in a different way than we did before. I will be releasing short topical videos like this as we move forward, and I will continue doing longer interview-style podcasts, but they will only be posted on our BitChute channel.